Freddie, in the last couple of weeks and months, you were working on solo stuff. Can you tell us a little bit what kind of things did you do?
This last couple of weeks, I have been working with this amazing woman. She's an big operatic star. Her name is Montserrat Caballé. She comes from Barcelona. And she just called up a few weeks ago and said she'd like to sing with me. So, of course, I fell flat on the floor. You know, I thought, my God. But I've loved her, you know, for years. And I think it worked when I went to Barcelona recently. So I did a TV show, and they asked me, you know, and I said, well, you know, she's the best singer in the world. And I'd love to be able to sing with her. So she must have read, well, she must have seen it. And so she called up the office and said she'd like to do things. So, well, last night, I mean, she sang one of my songs at the Royal Opera House. So it's amazing. I mean, now I'm going into opera, you know, forget rock and roll.
This is a new experience, an exciting experience.
Absolutely, it's such a challenge, actually. It's going to be great because I've never sort of thought of writing songs in that way. Now, she said she wants to do duets with me. I have to sort of think in a totally different way. And actually, I'm sure the opera critics will, you know, slam it and everything. But I mean, this is something that it's a good challenge at this time in life, you know.
Is it true that you are planning to do a whole album with her?
Yes. Well, you see, I went and saw her a week ago, and I just thought maybe one song or a duet and that. And she said things like, only one song? Are you sure? You only want to do one song? And I said, well, let's see how we get on, you know, if you like more of my music. And she said, how many songs does a normal rock and roll album have? And I said something like 10. Oh, we'll do 10 songs then. So, you know, so she just said, yes, write 10 songs, like tomorrow.
So you have to write songs in Spanish?
Yes.
In other
languages? Yeah, things like that. Because, I mean, I said, you know, I said, yes, we have to sort of, I said, I'll write the songs, and then you have to come in the studio and sort of try out things. So she said, she looked up her schedule, and she said, well, I have 3 days to spare in May, and that's all. And she thinks she can just come in and do it, and that's the way they work, you see. So she says she thinks in 3 days she'll probably just come in and sing the whole, so I've got to have it all prepared. But I think 3 days is pushing it.
You had a great success with your solo single, A Great Pretender.
Yes.
Here in England. Can you tell us when and the idea to pick the song and why?
Well, yes, I wanted to do a cover version, you know, a long time ago. And you can't do that with Queen, you know, because, I mean, we just write our own sort of original material. And I've always had that in the back of my head. And this song was the one I always wanted to do. So last Christmas, it was well before Christmas, I went into the studio and sort of tried out a few trials. And I liked it. It sort of suited my voice. It's a great sort of song to sing. So I sort of went ahead and I just said, well, I'll release it as a fun single. And then what happens? I mean, when it came out, there was this huge resurge of old things. So, I mean, it looked like I jumped on the bandwagon or something. But luckily, it came out on the front end as well, because now there's about 15 or 20. And if it came, like, even 2 weeks later, it would have looked like I ran into the studios to try and do that. But I'm glad it just happened. I think it happened at the right time. Most of the stuff I do is pretending. It's like acting, you know. So you go on stage and I pretend to be a macho man and all that. And then in my videos, you know, you go through all the different characters and then you're pretending anyway. So I think it's a great title for what I do, and it sort of suited to what I was doing. I mean, although the meaning in the song of how it was is all to do with love, that he's pretending about love. But I mean, I sort of take it a stage further, I think, you know. The way I see it is that I'm pretending, you know. But all this is a pretense, you know, and it's just fun.
Maybe do you see the whole rock and roll thing as a game that you play instead of being your life, or is it?
Well, I think it is, because I mean, when say I can only go by my own experiences. When I go on stage, I'm acting out a certain role. I mean, when I come off it, I mean, I don't carry on that way, otherwise I'd be dead. I mean, I'm, you know. So it's like a pretense, you know. When you go on stage, you sort of go through different moods and so on, and you're putting on, you know, you change a costume and you become somebody else, and then after that, you're your own person. So it's.
In your video for that song, you went to different roles and you also redid scenes of very well-known videos. Can you tell us about the idea? How that came?
Well, yes, in fact, that's what we're talking about now, is that I wanted to show people that all these different roles that I was doing in video was a kind of pretense, that I was pretending. And to bring them back, I had to sort of choose key roles that I did in the past, and then to try and marry them with the word pretender and things like that. So basically, we just had different mini sets built all the way around the studios, and I just sort of recreated some of the things in my costumes, and then we just sort of bridged the two together with lighting sort of technique and things. Hello, my name is Freddie Mercury, and this is my latest recording, The Great Pretender.
Camera.
Hello, my name is Freddie Mercury, and this is my latest recording, The Great Pretender. I think it's too long, isn't it? Hello, I'm Freddie Mercury, and this is my new recording, The Great Pretender.
Cut it. Okay.